Welcome to Theology for Everyone series. This video lecture is the second part of what we have learned in the previous week. Topic of today's video is Attributes of God, Part 2. If you have not watched the last week's video lecture, please find the link in the description and watch it first. Let's continue what we have started to discuss in last week. There are two categories of attributes of God. Number one, incommunicable attributes. Number two, communicable attributes. Let's discuss some of the incommunicable attributes which belongs to God alone. Number one, incorporeality. This attribute of God simply means God is spirit. This attribute denotes the very essence of his existence. Look at what Christ taught the woman at the well. God is spirit, and his worshippers must worship in spirit and in truth. What does it mean when we say God is spirit? It means God is not a matter. By definition, matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. Matter is made up of particles known as atoms. Atoms are the basic building blocks of ordinary matter. Whatever objects you see around, such as a cat, insects, balloons, fruits, candle, sun, planets, and everything are made of atoms. Therefore, they are all matter. All these things have mass and limited to space. When we learn Einstein's theory of relativity, we come to know the fact that space and time are not two different entities. They both are the two sides of the same thing called space-time. Therefore, when we say matter is limited to space, it is also limited to time. But God does not fall in this category since God is spirit. God is not made of atoms, and thus he is not a matter. Since God is not a matter, he is not limited by space and time. God not being limited to time points to another attribute of God, that he is eternal. This means that God exists from everlasting to everlasting. He is not subject to time, aging, or death. In Psalms 90 verse 2, Moses sings, "Before the mountains were brought forth, or you ever had formed the earth and the world, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God." This means there is no moment in the history of the entire universe is hidden from God. His attribute of eternality shows that God can easily know the past, present, and future of everything that exists in the universe simultaneously. When we know that God knows our past, present, and future, we can be assured that he knows and understands what we went through in the past, he guides in what we are facing in the present, and his plans for our future will prevail. Secondly, God not being limited to space shows that he is omnipresent. Omnipresence of God denotes that God is always present in all places at all times. King David beautifully sang of God's omnipresence in Psalm 139 verses 7 through 10. "Where shall I go from your spirit? Or where shall I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me and your right hand shall hold me." As our God is always present in all places at all times, we can be assured that his presence is with us wherever we go. Whenever we pray and worship our Lord Jesus, we can experience the intense presence of God regardless of wherever we are. God can be present among the saints of different countries at the same time and listen to our prayers simultaneously. And we can never hide from God to to do anything in secret too. Therefore, none of our sins would be hidden from him. God, being present everywhere at every time, brings forth his next attribute, that he is omniscient. This attribute of God means that he knows everything. As God exists from everlasting to everlasting and being present everywhere at every point of time, it's very obvious that he knows everything in the history of universe. Psalm 147 verse 5 says, "Great is our Lord and mighty in power, his understanding has no limit." Because our God is all-knowing, we can trust that he knows everything we are going through today and everything we will go through tomorrow. That's why King David also sings in Psalms 139 verse 4, "Even before a word is on my tongue, behold, O Lord, you know it altogether." God, who exists from everlasting to everlasting, present everywhere, every time, and knows everything, should be all-powerful. Yes, God is omnipotent. It means that God has unlimited authority and infinite power. Isaiah 44 verse 24 says, "Thus says the Lord, your Redeemer, who formed you from the womb. I am the Lord, who made all things, who alone stretched out the heavens, who spread out the earth by myself." God created the entire universe out of nothing, and thus he is powerful enough to change anything and everything that exists. God is capable of solving any problem of your life, regardless of how huge and impossible it seems. Angel Gabriel said to Mary in Luke 1 verse 37, "For nothing will be impossible with God." God himself asked prophet Jeremiah, "Behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is anything too hard for me?" There are so many other scriptural references that denote the omnipotence of God. When we meditate on these incommunicable attributes of God, especially in light of his other attributes of goodness and love, it makes it easier to trust him with all we have going on in our lives, from the very serious to the silly and mundane. In the upcoming videos, we will continue to learn more about the attributes of God and how this learning can be spiritually encouraging. Thanks for watching this video. I hope this video is informative and encouraging. Please share this video with your Christian friends and family. Thank you. We'll be right back.